It's time to enter the world of real estate in Oahu with Hawaii's only true real estate radio show, the Team Lally Real Estate Show. Grab a pen and get ready to take notes. For the next full hour, Hawaii's premier real estate leader, Adrienne Lally, and Attilio Leonardi will bring you the latest in real estate news and real-world strategies on how they can guarantee to sell your home at a price and deadline you agree to, or they'll buy it. Now, here are your hosts, Adrienne and Attilio.
Welcome to the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the Guaranteed Sold program, or we'll buy it. If you have any questions, just give us a call at 799-9596 or check us out online at teamlally.com.
Hey, everybody, this is Attilio, and this is the part of the show where we do art. And Adrienne, what is art?
It is Attilio's random thoughts.
Well, so what I do is I write these thoughts down in a nice journal that I have. And so I have, first of all, Adrienne, what are the benefits of taking notes?
It helps you with retention.
What else?
It shows the person that's in front of you that what they're saying is important.
Yeah. So here, two sides of the coin. One is it creates a better learning. It facilitates better learning, better retention. You can't go back to your notes if you don't have them. You can't reference your notes if you don't take them. And is exactly what you just said. It tells the person who's presenting information to you that what they're saying is important. So if you're any type of consultative type business where you're working with clients,
take notes. If
they're spending more than a dollar for your services, you should be taking notes.
Yes. It helps to manage the evidence. Right. Well, and for you to remember what you need to do and action items to follow up on.
Yeah. So here's something to remember. And this is from university professors that had done studies of students taking notes versus not versus test scores. Mm-hmm. They tested higher. So it's evidence-based information is what I'm sharing with you, not just anecdotal. And more importantly, allows you to reconfigure that information in a way that makes sense for you, as opposed to the way that it's being presented to you by the presenter. So I want to share with you some notes that I took. That's where I was going with this.
Thank you.
So here's a quote
for sharing your notes.
Here's a quote from Mark Twain. Mm-hmm. And this quote was shared at a TED Talk presentation by the director currently of the largest, or not the largest, but the longest running human study. And this was a Harvard study that was started back in the, I think, late 20s, early 30s with a group of Harvard freshmen, as well as men of the similar age, but inner city Boston. So different ends of the spectrum economics, different ends of the spectrum as far as education. And he ended with this quote from this study and what they had learned. And here's the quote from Mark Twain. Looking back on his life, there isn't a time, so brief is life, for bickerings, apologies, heartburnings, callings to account. There is only time for loving and but an instant, so to speak, for that. What does that mean to you, Adrienne?
I was trying to see how this is tied into this longest running human study. Like, basically, how are you going to tie this Mark Twain quote into this study?
Well, here's what Mark Twain, you know, Mark Twain was a very notable literary person in history, very wise person, great observer of the human race. And what he said is that, I'll read the last line for you. There is only time for loving and but an instant, so to speak, for that. And I know it's flowery language and maybe the syntax is in a way that maybe we don't quite understand today because we don't speak in that format. But what he's saying is that life is short, and you need to focus on loving. So that's the flowery frou-frou part of it. Here's the data for all you nerds out there. They're like, forget that frou-frou stuff.
Tell me about the study.
The data. Here's the data, what they studied. So interesting statistics, and I've heard the Harvard study be quoted regarding goals for people in the Harvard graduating class. And you're talking like some of these graduates were presidents of the United States. One was a president of the United States. CEOs of major corporations, multi-billionaires, and some of them died penniless in a park. Mm. But majority of them were on the other end of the spectrum. And here's what they found. Regardless of whether they were the Harvard graduates with all this education or the inner city Boston kids, as they studied these men throughout their lives, they found that the men that were had less disease, they were more lucid. They had more control of all of their faculties into the later stages of their life. They had these things in common. You ready for the things in common?
I'm ready. That was a lot of buildup for this longest running human study.
They had close relationships. Hmm. Close relationships. What they even found in the study is that if, for example, talking about, you know, couples or married couples versus people that were divorced or alone, obviously the ones that were married had greater connection.
They lived longer?
So they lived longer. What they found, here's the data. They had better cognitive ability, mm-hmm. Less likely having any kind of memory or age issues like Parkinson's or Alzheimer's. Mm-hmm. Again, there was no direct connection, but this was the causality and what they noticed in this large group.
I think it kind of ties into the studies that we learned about the blue zones,
yeah,
right, where people have this sense of community and they're eating healthy and they're working and they're moving every day and connecting with each other.
Yeah. So that they found was the older men that were healthy, mm-hmm. regardless if they were wealthy or not, everything seemed to rotate around their relationships. Mm-hmm. So they had close friend relationships, long-term friendship relationships. You know, I was just in I went to the hospital today to just do one of those healthcare
checkups,
well-being checkups. Mm-hmm. I used to get them a lot. Thank you to Servco, one of the awesome companies I used to work with. They're awesome to their employees. They every year they have like Kaiser and HMSA come in and do a wellness checkup in the office.
Wow.
Blood tests, all that kind of stuff. Anyway, they asked me a bunch of questions, and these are questions that I had not heard before. Mm-hmm. How often do you spend time with loved ones and relatives? Once a day? Once a week? How often do you speak with them? How often do you visit with them? Those were the intake questions for my basic health check-in over at the clinic over at Queens Medical. Mm-hmm. I think it's Empower Health. It's some kind of new corporate name that they have. But they just opened up in Neva Beach in the Ocean Point area. Thank you so much for awesome coming in there. But this was part of the intake. The questions like this.
Well, because like you said, with the study, your emotional health really ties into your physical health.
Yes.
They're interconnected.
So from this study that's been going on for almost 75 years, that information, that data is now showing up in our modern medicine today. So,
that's amazing.
Speaking of modern medicine and breakthroughs in real estate and technology and all the good things that might be happening on the Big Island, we've got Dan. Hey, Dan. Dan from the Big Island, Keller Williams.
Hey, guys. How are you? I was going to mention something about that, Attilio, because you just don't call and write and chat like you used to with me anymore.
Yeah.
You know, and I feel very neglected.
I got to check in with you so you can live longer.
You guys can both live longer by staying connected.
Stay connected.
That's right.
I don't feel like we're connected, so I want to put that on your survey.
That's okay. I'll be like the AT&T commercial. I'll reach out and touch someone. So what's new over there, Dan?
Well, the numbers are in. You know, everybody's analyzing the numbers from 2020, trying to take a look at what trends or what we could predict or what's the future going to hold. And everyone loves to rub the crystal ball. And I don't know if looking at the past is always a great indication of what's going to happen in the future. However, it seems like when you look at the numbers for the Big Island in 2020, you're going to get a mixed bag. And what I mean by that is there's several reports out there that show that the number of sales island-wide are down between, I would say, 13% and 26%, depending upon where you are. So, however, it's a different story if you're talking about luxury. For instance, and you know, guys know I do a lot in luxury, and you know, I was studying the price point where I do the most work, which is between $2 million and $7 million. And if you look at the number of sales in 2019 between $2 million and $7 million, there were 62 sales or 62 buyers. But in 2020, there were 132
sales. So it doubled.
In that price range.
More than doubled. Wow.
And that's you know, that's really a function of COVID. And really people trying to escape whatever, either a social unrest that they're living in or whatever lockdown they're living in.
Mm-hmm.
And, it, you know, as we've talked about before, COVID brought forth the reality that people can do their jobs pretty much from anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
And so why not do it, with a terrific view and great weather?
Yeah.
And I think
I agree.
That's the you know, that's the primary driver of the double in luxury sales. The down number of sales in general, I would think it would be a mistake to contribute that directly to COVID. Part of that would be the fact that we've just had really, really low inventory.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So when you don't have as many homes to sell, you're not going to have the same numbers of sold product at the end of the year.
So it wasn't because lack of interest; it was more lack of inventory to sell was the main driver of those lower numbers. Dan,
yeah, I think people could connect the two and say, well, people didn't put their houses on the market or sell their properties because of the uncertainty of COVID, and that could be true.
And then, Dan, you had mentioned the luxury market, and I remember it was like a few months back we were talking about that one of the benefits of being part of Keller Williams, you had gotten an amazing referral from one of our other Keller Williams agents of a beautiful luxury home. Is that one, that still available, or did that one fly off the shelves with the rest?
It's still available because it's on the higher end of the spectrum at $18 million.
Mm-hmm. $18 million.
But
you know what? I'll be right over.
We've had some very wealthy renters that have rented it for the last few months, two different parties, and they've enjoyed it. We have been able to show it about a half a dozen times, I would say, to well-qualified people, and so it's just a matter of trying to find the right buyer for that house.
And this house does have a website, right? So if any of our listeners
is the website?
Yeah, shout that out.
Yeah, just right on the front page of mine, it's the HawaiiTeam.com, HawaiiTeam.com. And it's called Honupani. And just click on that and check it out. We would love to get it sold to the right person. And there's a number of other high-end listings that I'm working on here for 2021 and in discussions with. And so there may be maybe more to look at from me and my team here soon.
Well, hey, you know, we're going to be having Ryan Serhan. He's one of those millionaire real estate guys from New York. He's actually going to be on our show coming up.
Yeah.
So we'll drop a little birdie into his ear because $18 million, that's par for the course for him.
That's like chump change for him.
Yeah, he does one of those every other week in New York.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe he'll have a buyer and we'll make a connection.
And then the other thing I want to point out too is that Dan is leading the agents there on the Big Island. And if you are looking to get in real estate or make a move and you want to learn more about luxury, about technology, about just business, you got to give Dan a call.
That's right. All right. Any last words,
Dan?
I'd
be happy to help you.
Mm-hmm.
No, just have a great weekend, guys. And we'll talk to you again in a couple of weeks.
All right. Thank you, Dan.
Thanks, Dan. All right, so you can get a hold of Dan at 960-6231. Again, that's 960-6231. He is with Keller Williams, Big Island.
What's that, Instagram, at KWBID?
I have no idea.
You know what? Google it, and it'll
Keller
probably
Williams,
take you where you
Big
need
Island.
To be.
Yes.
But it's Keller Williams, Big Island, Dan.
Yes.
He's
making stuff up.
We're just making stuff up. But anyway, we have brokerages on all the islands. We've got them on Kauai.
Mm-hmm.
We have them on Maui. We have them on the Big Island. We're both in Kona and Hilo, and as well as here on Oahu. And we've got offices in, what, Kailua, Kahala,
so, bottom line is, Kapolei. If you're here in Hawaii, you can be part of the Keller Williams
brand. And you know what? Here's your number one resource tools. For that. All you got to do is Google Team Lally. Mm-hmm. What's that Google again? Team Lally.
Just Google it.
Yeah. So I want to talk about, I don't know if he gave the HBR report.
He talked about the Big Islands.
Okay.
So we can talk about Oahu.
So I'm going to talk about Oahu. Yes. Here's the stats, because we are a real estate show, but mm-hmm. What I like to do with our show is focus more on the learning and the growth opportunities that we can share with our listeners, as well as entertain and educate at the same time, which we call
edutainment.
Edutainment. So anyway, here's the educating part on Oahu. The median single family price, so closing out on the last month from the statistics from the Honolulu Board of Realtors for December, $870,000. A couple of interesting, notable pieces of data. Condos, $450,000. And both of those numbers are up from a year ago. And again, mortgage rates are still a record low.
They are.
Yeah. So I can share you with you couple more statistics, but before we do that, let's bring on our Allstate insurance guy. His name is Bradley. Hey, Bradley.
Maruyama.
Hey, how's it going?
You know, Adrian's come a long way. She always had a hard time with your last name, and
that is not true. I never
had Mama Yama.
That is not true.
And I was like, it's Maruyama. Bradley.
Bradley Maruyama.
So,
welcome back.
What you got for us this week?
Okay, so week after week, we always talk about reviewing your insurance policies.
But, yes.
You know, with all these new purchases going on, you know, last night at about 8 o'clock, one of the realtors that, you know, sends me some referrals says, hey, Brad, can you take a look at this quote? To me, it seems kind of high. So we were able to re-quote it apples to apples and save the new home buyer about $370 per year. So my tip of the day is, even if your loan officer or your current insurance carrier sends you a quote, it doesn't hurt to get a second opinion or another quote to make sure that you're getting the absolutely cheapest price when you're going through your first purchase.
I think that means that you're going to be a smart consumer, right? You want to be a smart consumer.
Yeah, get a second opinion because you never know. I mean, that $276 or $300 per year could mean qualifying and not qualifying. So. Mm-hmm. You know, it doesn't hurt to get a second opinion or a second quote just to make sure that what you're getting is the best product and best price that you can get for your first purchase.
No, I think you're going to be smart. You're going to be Akamai. Oh, but that's Hawaiian for the same thing.
You know what else doesn't hurt? To have Bradley and his team review what you already have and make sure that you're not underinsured or overinsured.
Yeah.
That doesn't hurt either.
Yeah. And what's good about it is, you know, I recently had a friend, we reviewed his homeowner's condo policy. And one thing that I've mentioned in prior shows is people don't realize that jewelry has limitations to it. So while we're reviewing his policy, I said, hey, by the way, blank and blank, you know, did you get any new jewelry for your wife during Christmas? So what he did, he got a little tennis bracelet and she wore it to golf and it broke and it was lost.
Ooh.
You know, $4,800 tennis bracelet. So we did, well, during a review, we did add it around Christmas time and she lost it last weekend. So, you know, it doesn't hurt to do these reviews and make sure that all the gaps are taken care of because, again, you want to make sure that when that claim happens, your agent isn't saying, ooh, that's not covered.
Hmm.
Because it's very uncomfortable for the agent and it's going to be very disturbing for the insurer.
Yeah, I saw it on Bradley's card, business card the other day. It says right at the bottom, you don't know what you don't know.
No, it says...
Call Bradley.
It says, the moment of truth.
The moment of truth.
Call Bradley.
Yeah. You know, we've had some good first-hand experience with our friend Bradley where with some insurance, and he's gone to bat for us.
Because mm-hmm.
I think a lot of times people are like, oh, I don't like insurance because they never want to help me out. And it's always denied the claim. But I tell you, that's not true with Bradley and his team.
He fights for his clients.
Yeah. Yeah,
and he makes sure that they've got the right kind of insurance.
Yeah, the adjuster had to get one TRO on Bradley because he was fighting so hard for us. But anyway.
Well, and sometimes, you know, to that point, you know, recently we were struggling with the AOAO and the property manager to get the as-built claim paid out. So even in that instance, even if we fulfilled our obligation on the Allstate side, sometimes I'll go to bat for my insurer to make sure I work with the association adjusters as well as the association to make sure that our insurance made whole. It's not my job, but, you know, our office tries to go that extra step because the insurers don't know how insurance works or what is the difference between the AOAO adjuster and the Allstate adjuster.
Mm-hmm.
Are they the same thing? Well, it's not. So sometimes because I understand the language, that's my job to go out there and say, hey, you know, AOAO adjuster, what about this? Did you measure that? Here's what our adjuster's got. Can you take a look at it and compare notes and see if we should be covering that extra room or should we not be covering it? So, you know, I think that's when we talk about the moment of truth.
Yeah.
I think that's that little extra value added you'll get from our office.
You know, Bradley's so tough. One time he went dress up like the taxi driver. He had on Mohawk, everything. And he was looking at the manager and he was like, you looking at me? You looking at me? I don't think you looking at me. You know, anyway. No, but no. This Bradley will go to, no, he's not like that. He does it in a diplomatic way.
He goes above and beyond to make sure that his clients are taken care of, even if it's not his job.
Because I'll tell you right now, most of you people right now listening to my voice, you probably don't even know who your insurance guy is. So maybe you should call Bradley. Bradley,
yes.
Local boy, were you born on Oahu or Kauai? I see for some reason.
I was born on Oahu.
You was born on Oahu, and then I know you had an office on Kauai for a long time, and you knew everybody. You probably still know everybody over there. Small island. And
keep in touch with everyone there.
Yeah, so Bradley's local boy, Allstate Insurance, give you
just
that.
Call him Mr. Aloha.
Mr. Aloha, you get it figured out. That's it in the moment of truth. Thank you, Bradley.
Thanks, Bradley.
Well, thank you. Have a great week.
You too.
All right, so you can get a hold of Bradley and his team at 591-8016. Check out the video and everything about Bradley under the Experts We Trust tab on teamlally.com under the resource page. We have all of them there, and we've got a couple of nice videos of Bradley.
By the way, other experts that we trust, we got one right now on the line. He's calling in from his home inspection helicopter. We have Kenji coming to us from the helicopter. No, Kenji, are you there?
Yes, I am. How are you guys today?
Good. So what's the latest in the world of home inspection?
Well, for right now, all I have is my tip of the day as far as that goes. Old-style window with a single pane that has the slider windows. Sometimes the framework actually separates from the glass itself.
Yeah.
So when you have guests over, family over, even a kid, when they're trying to open up the window, the finger might actually get pinched between the glass and the framework because they're trying to open it so hard.
Yeah.
So that's where the safety whole aspect comes in, and where we come in is we test all that to make sure that it is safe for kids, adults, friends, and family that try to open up with these windows. So it's a real small little thing, but at the end of the day, it could create a cut, laceration, and eventually going to the hospital to get it stitched or, bandaged up. So that's a little bit for today.
Yeah, you know, that reminds me of a story. You know, people accuse me of being full of lots of things, but you know what I'm mostly full of is stories.
Hmm.
And I'm going to share one with you all right now. So had one, you ever notice this, Kenji, if you look on the inside of the screen, there's a little sticker with a warning that says, it's something about like, be careful with small children, with the screen, because, we have good weather, we open up the window, and then they have the screen. And what do kids like to do when there's a screen and a window? And they're jumping on the bed and they're looking outside. They like to lean on the screen. And this is a true story because it says, be careful, and it's got a warning on there because the screen is not meant to hold the kids inside the house. And so it will come off and flop off. So we had some friends, the husband had come home from work, he was in the driveway, luckily it was first floor. The kids are all on top of the bed, little kids, waving to daddy, hi, daddy, and leaned onto the screen. The screen popped open. The little child flopped out, broke her arm.
Oh.
So she had a cast. True story. These are friends of ours. So be careful with those screens, especially on the especially on the second floor. They are not meant to keep the child in. So if you have a bed up against the wall and there's a window there, make sure that we're keeping those closed with the little ones if they,
Put the safety features on.
Yeah.
Safety features on those windows.
You got to keep the window closed or,
Keep an eye on your kids.
Keep an eye on your kids. They're like, Where'd Jessie go? Oh, she's in the front yard. I thought she was upstairs a moment ago. No, she fell through the screen. So be careful with that and take a look at your screens in your home. But all right. Thank you, Kenji.
Thanks, Kenji. All right. So you can get a hold of Kenji and his team. He's with Pillar to Post Home Inspections at 492-1675. We also have his information under the Experts We Trust on the Team Lally resource page.
Yeah. So if you guys need to, you know, maybe you're having a hard time navigating through the big selection and choices of vendors or experts, all you got to do is go to our, you just Google Team Lally, go to Experts We Trust. It's in the resources tab.
That's right.
And all these people, so.
Our resources are your resources.
And if they're horrible, they stay up there, right?
No.
No, we take them down.
We're done.
We take them on the side. We bust them up and say, hey, don't be so horrible. And then we say, maybe you get better. You can come back and be one of our, no, we've never had any issues. We do a lot of research. We represent a lot of business, and we want our customers to receive the same level of service that we do. So we really take the time to check out these experts.
All right. Well, we're going to take a short break, but stay with us. When we come back, we'll be talking with Dr. Patel, and we're going to talk about the innovative and individualistic
approach to care provided by his team at Aloha Surgical Care. So stay with us.
This is Scotty B from News Radio 830 KHVH. Well, do you have a friend who's having a hard time selling their home? Well, be a real friend to them and tell them about Adrian and Attilio, the agents who guarantee to sell their home. Anna and Aldwin needed to liquidate an investment property in Waikiki to help fund their retirement, but they were concerned about the pandemic. So they hired Adrian and Attilio. The marketing went into full gear, including the 3D interactive tours, a large social media push, and it sold for top dollar in only 6 days. Anna and Aldwin can now continue to enjoy their retirement. They are so confident in their marketing strategy. Team Lally will guarantee to sell your home at a price and deadline you agree to, or they're going to buy it. Life does happen. There's things that will come up. And if you need to get out of the contract, they'll let you out at any time. Adrian Lally, Attilio Leonardi of Team Lally Real Estate Group of Keller Williams, Honolulu. Give them a call today at 799-9596. 799-9596. You want to go online, check them out there. You can do that at teamlally.com. That's teamlally.com.
Hey, it's Sean Hannity here, and I know the business climate has changed dramatically, but if you need to sell your home, don't believe the myth that homes aren't selling. Joining me now is a true expert at selling homes, Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi of Team Lally Real Estate Group of Keller Williams, Honolulu. So what's your advice on selling a home right now?
Sean, our real estate team has always been on the cutting edge with technology. We're using FaceTime for showing homes with buyers and keeping our buyers and sellers safe with a virtual showing at any time and any place. We've sold hundreds of homes this way.
So what does that mean for sellers?
Sean, ignore the fake news. This is an incredible opportunity for sellers. Supply has plummeted. Demand has skyrocketed. People still have to move. We have thousands of motivated buyers ready to buy. We eliminate the tire kickers, conduct the virtual showing safely, quickly, and conveniently to sell their homes.
All right. Thanks so much. Look, talk to the agent that I trust for the best advice. Call Team Lally now at 799-9596. Online at 808GuaranteedSale.com.
If you're looking for an outstanding insurance agent that will personally help you during the moment of truth, we recommend Bradley Maruyama with Allstate Insurance.
So, Attilio, what do you mean by the moment of truth?
Well, the best insurance is the insurance you never have to use, but we know that's not how life works. So when life happens, you can count on Bradley and his team to exceed your expectations for your insurance needs.
Keep in mind that when buying a home, the cost of home insurance should be taken into consideration. I trust Bradley with my own personal home, so you should give him a call. Call Bradley with Allstate Insurance at 591-801.
Hi, I'm Barbara Corcoran. I hope every family will stay healthy and safe during these uncertain times. Our real estate market is experiencing many challenges every day. If you're planning to move or sell your home now, be sure to get the most current information from the best agent in your marketplace. In Honolulu, you should call Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi. You'll need an agent who is trusted in your community and understands your needs. Go online or call and please stay safe.
The the Team Lally Real Estate Show continues. Give it to me, I'm worth it.
Welcome back, and thanks for listening to the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the Guaranteed Sold program, or we'll buy it. I'm Adrian.
And I'm Attilio.
And if you have any questions, just give us a call at 799-9596 or on the web at teamlally.com. So our guest today is a highly skilled and respected gastrointestinal endoscopic surgeon practicing at Aloha Surgical Care located here on Oahu.
Oh man, I was nervous. Those are some big words over there. He's here today to talk about the innovative and individualistic approach to care provided by his team at Aloha Surgical Care Incorporated. Please welcome our guest, Dr. Anand Patel. Hi, Doctor. Dr. Patel.
Hello.
Hi.
Thank you for
I was gonna go like
having me today.
Yeah, I was gonna go. Paging Dr. Patel? Paging Dr. Patel.
Hilarious. Just like, yeah, I'm just like, as if I'm at work right now.
Yes.
Well, you've been busy.
Thank you so much for having me.
Yes, sure, you're welcome. So we heard that you've been super busy during this whole last 2020 building this this new facility. Actually, it's in Kapolei, right?
What's the name of the facility?
Yep. It's Aloha Surgical Care is the name of the corporation.
Okay.
We are at 590 Farrington Highway, which is the where the Safeway market is at.
Oh, so you're in the Safeway. Gotcha.
That's right, yeah. So we're right in that mall, and we've been seeing patients. We just actually opened about 3 months ago. And yeah, exactly. We're very busy, but we're always happy to help anyone who needs help.
So basically, even if you're born and raised here and people lived there all their lives, our medical system can be a little bit confusing. But in general, typically patients are finding their way to you because they're referred to you by their general practitioner or their family care physician?
That's correct. Yeah, generally that's the way to go because they have a surgical issue when it comes to those types of things. But
yeah.
Some people have things that they are aware of, like hernias, for example.
Mm-hmm.
They're aware they need a colonoscopy. That's where the endoscopic portion comes in. I do a lot of things where you put cameras into different places that people need on a regular basis. As we're all getting older, they're recommending an age of 45. It used to be 50 for a colonoscopy, for example. So that's something I do help out with.
Now, I know the colonoscopy is like the platinum gold standard for, colon health or early detection, right, for colon cancer?
Absolutely correct.
Yeah.
Absolutely correct.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, not enough people know that, so I'm glad you're putting the word out there.
Yeah.
Colon cancer is very much an American disease. I think it has to do with our environment. I think it's our diet. We eat well.
Yeah. We eat well, and then we pay for it. We pay for it on the back end, as we say. But no, it's interesting because I am one of those weird kids. On Saturday, I didn't watch Justice League with Super Friends. I watched documentaries. I was watching like Mutual of Omaha, the Animal Kingdom, and stuff like that. But to this day, my kids hate it when I have the remote and I'm on the Netflix. They're like, oh boy, we're going to watch another documentary. Dad's got the remote. And so I watched one recently and they showed it was the China study, and they were studying rates of colon cancer in Japan, pre-war and post-war versus the United States. In the United States, we had a ton. But then in Japan, where the per capita was super low, all of a sudden it started spiking. And you know why? McDonald's.
Mm.
Western diet.
This is it.
Yep.
That's the thing. We're spreading around the world, as it turns out. But the good thing is, if we catch it early, it's very easy to treat.
Yes.
Particularly in what we call a weed stage or a polyp stage, where we're very early. Just pull the weed out.
Yeah.
We just pull the polyp out, you're done.
Yeah.
And if you happen to have a cancer, which is early, which is undetectable, at this point in time, you're not having problems. If we find it early, surgery alone can cure you before even chemotherapy. And the rates are very good of success and survival in when it's very early. And that's the best thing, right? You want to catch it early, not when it's too late.
So you're not only doing the is it typical that the person doing the colonoscopy is also the endoscopic surgeon?
No, not really.
Because you are. You're both.
That's my specialty. I trained at the Cleveland Clinic where, you know, endoscopy was advanced endoscopy was invented by surgeons. Mm-hmm. So for me to be doing endoscopy, I've been doing this for 20 years. I didn't think too much of it. And, of course, I went on to do sort of training in a fellowship program in order to do more advanced endoscopies. Colonoscopy is a little bit more of the lower end, but I do even a higher advanced endoscopies, as well as minimally invasive surgery for these problems that we may run into.
Yeah.
So, doctor,
I'm sorry, go ahead.
Oh, I was going to say, so Dr. Patel, what made you open this clinic out on the west side? What was that driving force?
A few different things. My family and I, we relocated to Oahu in the last 5 years, or 4 years now, I think. Mm-hmm. And we've been wanting to come here for many years. We realized, where's the need? Where are people at?
Yeah.
People don't like to come to town.
Mm-hmm.
So we want to help them. For one person to come over, myself, to come to the west side where things are growing, as opposed to everyone driving to town. What's the point?
I know. You go do a healthcare check-in in town, and you're like, well, what's stressing you out? The drive here.
The traffic.
It's just stressing me out.
And that's so true. People would rely, you know, particularly when you don't need something. When mm-hmm. in your mind, when there's a problem, then you go do something. But when it's preventative medicine, the types of things I'm providing, is like, maybe I'll go next week, I'll go to the afterwards, then next year, and all of a sudden, it's way too long. Just like, I'm no different. I don't want to go to the dentist, and I don't want to go to the doctor either. But mm-hmm. can we make it easier for patients and make sure we take care of them?
Yeah.
So
I want to bring that to the west side.
Yeah. And we appreciate that because, obviously, like, our team works all over the island, but both Attilio and myself, we live over on the west side, and it's nice to have these resources and not have to drive to town.
Yeah, because then you got to, like, anytime you have, if you have an AM appointment in town, you got to leave, like, a week early. And then you got to go rent a room at a hotel in Waikiki, and then maybe you make it on time. It's just, you know, I was driving my daughter she's back to college, drop her off at the airport, and I was like, dang, I guess COVID's bouncing back because the traffic was back. And we also have, you know, people that are listeners in the audience that either have children that are going off to college or they're college age kids. What made you decide to get into the medical field?
Wow, I think that the easiest to start off with is that you look up to your dad. And my dad is a primary care physician,
mm-hmm.
and I wanted to be like him. And when I went to medical school, I saw what primary care was like, and I said, Daddy, how are you doing this? I don't want to do this at all.
Yeah.
So after that, I just kind of, I think like most of us, we just kind of find our way. And the thing that appealed to me, I like working my hands, I like working hard. That's what surgeons actually, you know, kind of do.
Yeah.
And then after that, the technology portion of things.
Yeah.
I really like how technology can help people, particularly with minimally invasive surgery. And that's kind of what I pursued the entire time, to find better ways of doing the things that we do. The surgery is great. You want to open somebody up and fix them, that's a wonderful thing. But there are disadvantages to that. And so that's where I started from. I like making small, tiny pukas into people and fixing them that way.
Yeah.
And that goes along with the endoscopic portion, too. And they almost don't even notice that anything happened to them. And in 2 weeks, they're back to their normal life. I think that's even better. Maybe one of these days, they'll have a pill. It'll be the pill doctor. You just take a pill, and everything goes away.
Well, it's like that.
We don't have that yet.
It was like that old 70s, what was it, like a science fiction movie where they shrank the people down into a tiny submarine and then they inject them into the bloodstream to go and fight it. So maybe we'll be there, but we're not there yet. So since you're on the west side, I need to give you a different title. Since you're on the west side, we're going to call you the Puka Surgeon.
All right. Oh, that's not a bad one. I like that.
Because people will be like, oh, I do endoscopic surgery and we do da-da-da-da. And then you're going to go, oh, I come in through a small puka. Oh, okay, now I understand what you do.
Mm-hmm.
So you're the puka surgeon. And because you're right, surgery can be an invasive procedure by itself. But if you can minimize that invasiveness with the endoscopic procedure, Even better, right? Because what are the benefits, right? Quicker healing times, back up, you know, everybody's up doing, going on the trampoline faster.
Once probably like a lower risk also, right?
Yes and no. You know, again, as long as you're trained in doing that, which I think, you know, many surgeons are trained nowadays.
Yes.
But if you're not trained in it, it is dangerous.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I think more and more as the last 20 or 30 years of the technology has been introduced with this, people are getting better at this.
Yeah.
I started with some of the more original things, and so I've been through the trials and tribulations of how things work.
Yeah.
Actually, I published a paper with a physician at Kuakini, probably, 20 years ago now, about how to do things minimally invasive with 0% injury rates.
Wow. Like,
so I think, you know, we want to continue pushing forward, and hopefully if I do a very good job, I will be outdated one of these days too, and one of these younger people can take over what I'm doing. I think we want always the best is what we want for the patient, right? The patient comes first. Everybody else comes second.
Yes, perfect.
So I think that's the most important thing.
So,
and so these techniques are important.
So Dr. Patel, you had mentioned that you really got excited by the technology in the medical field. Is there anything with your particular practice that is new and advanced with the technology that our listeners could be
medical
excited
technology,
about?
Well, on Oahu now, we are starting to introduce robot surgery more and more.
Ooh.
It's one of the newer things. And one of the places I work is at Polymovie. Mm-hmm. They are just advanced, brought in a new robot. The first generation is out, now the second generation is in. I know Queens is looking at doing that on the west side here. But those types of things are also advantageous to the patients.
Yeah.
As we uncover more and more how we can use this properly for the patient. Remember cassette tapes and 8-track, you know, mm-hmm. they go out of the way, and then STDs, and we're not using those anymore. But it's important for us to examine and see how it helps the patient.
Yeah.
If it doesn't, let's move on to the next thing. But robots are looking pretty decent right now.
So yeah, and you're,
that's one of my also my specialties.
Yeah, and you're talking some high-tech stuff, because you're not talking like the Roomba, you know, the thing that rolls around on your floor cleaning up your crumbs. Most people don't realize.
I must admit, I'm pretty impressed, though.
Well, that Roomba's pretty good. It's like, hey, but I don't know if I trust that Roomba with a colonoscopy,
No. But
not that I don't have that trust level with that Roomba yet. But most people don't realize, robots are in a lot of industries that you're not even aware of. Auto manufacturing, a lot of manufacturing use robots. And, you know, next thing you know, they're going to be assisting and or helping with doctors because they're very precise. And all of that good stuff. So, all right, Dr. Patel. So if somebody's visiting their primary care and they're at that age, either they something's coming up or not, like you said, you're not going to know, but they're just doing their first time colonoscopy, and how do they end up with you, especially if they're here on the west side or they're at, you know.
Or they just want to come see you because they heard you on the Team Lally radio show.
Yes.
How do they connect up?
If I can share my telephone number.
Yes.
Okay.
My office number is, of course, 808-468-4144.
Mm-hmm.
And then my website is www.aloha-surgical.com.
Gotcha. So,
and so those are, I think the best ways to get, of course, get a hold of me, and I think Team Lally will be able to help out with that as well. Call you and say, hey, I can't get this guy.
Sure.
We'll direct you. We know how to find you.
The other thing too, so if somebody's visiting with their primary care physician, if they say Dr. Patel, Aloha Surgical Care, will that get them routed to you?
I sure hope so. Yeah, definitely. Okay. That's what we want to do. Yeah.
Because then that'll be, they said, hey, I heard I'm on the show. They're going to go to your website. They're going to check it out. A lot of times we defer to the primary care physician, and they maybe, I don't know, it could be a brand new doctor. They don't know the ropes yet, but then we know Dr. Patel, and, you know, how many years of experience,
and
Dr. Patel?
We're spreading the word.
Yeah, spreading the word. All right, so... Go ahead, Dr. Patel.
I think I'd be more than happy to touch base with anyone who needs some help, and of course, informing the people what we can do to help them.
All righty.
Stay healthy. Enjoy Oahu.
All right. Thank you, Dr. Patel.
Thank you.
And thank you both for your time. I appreciate it.
And you too. And congratulations on the new space.
The new clinic.
Yes.
All right. And what's that number again?
Okay. So you can get a hold of Dr. Patel at 808-468-4144. Again, that's 468-4144. Check them out online at aloha-surgical.com.
I think I know where his clinic is because I was at Koa Pancake House over there. Mm-hmm. So in Kapolei, they got Safeway across the way. In the same kind of shopping center, Kapolei Marketplace is, everybody knows where Koa Pancake House, but they're between Safeway and Koa Pancake House.
All right.
So.
All right. So we've got a few minutes left in our show. You want to go back to our real estate stats?
Yeah. So I got some stats here we were sharing earlier. Mm-hmm. You know, before I do that, I want to tell everybody other media's information, streams of information that we provide to people. So every Friday, we live stream on our Facebook and YouTube. So typically...
Oh, and now LinkedIn too.
And now LinkedIn. Mm-hmm. So we're live streaming on those...
11:30.
Wait.
11:30.
Oh, yeah, 11:30.
Every Friday.
I don't know what the time is. I just show up and start talking. No, we prepare. So 11:30, we live stream on LinkedIn, Facebook, YouTube. Mm-hmm. And then we do, now we're doing a new thing called Clubhouse, which what is Clubhouse? You know, I call it like audio, it's the audio version of Facebook.
It's a new platform where people can come together and share and have a good discussion with others around the world. So we have started or committed to a weekly Clubhouse room every Wednesday at 3:30 Hawaii time.
Yeah.
So if you're on Clubhouse, follow us. We'd love to have more of a dialogue with
Wednesdays
any of our
at 3:30. Yep. Clubhouse. Now, here's the deal. It's in the beta stages right now, and it's really rolling out, and there's a lot of expert people on there, famous people that are on there. Mm-hmm. You can only get on if you're invited.
Yeah. But so you can also load the app and get on a wait list, and hopefully you'll be let in soon.
Yeah. And once you get in there, too, other people that know you will get invites, and then everybody gets 4 invites. So, you know, go make nice with somebody.
That's right.
All right.
Do we have any other announcements you'd like to touch on?
Well, we always have our career night. So if you go to HawaiiCareerNight.com, HawaiiCareerNight.com, it's every other month. It's typically the first Monday from 5 to 6. And we're going to talk about what it takes to get into the real estate career and all the different costs, time, and expenses.
So our next career night is actually in March.
Okay.
And then the other event that we do every other month is a webinar or a Zoom meeting on the DST.
Yeah, so that's what we'll be talking about at the Clubhouse. And I'm going to give you Miller Lite, you know, less filling tastes great. DST, Delaware Statutory Trust, it's an opportunity or a type of way to invest in real estate, institutional grade type real estate from a 1031 exchange.
Yes, so we'll be talking more on Clubhouse about that, as well as we do have a page on our website, teamlally.com/DST. We have some past trainings there, as well as if you do want to book a time to talk about your particular situation or your unique questions, there's an information form there. You can fill that out.
And I would remind everybody, you know, a lot of people make the websites and then they're outdated and they still got stuff from 1990.
We're constantly
updating it. The page you probably want to bookmark if you want to go straight to it is called Resources. Team Lally, and the drop-down is Resources.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Anything else? Well...
We've got open houses this weekend.
Oh, yeah. Open houses.
Oh, yeah.
People can walk in, wear your mask. We're going to have a whole bunch of safety protocols.
We've got a lot of new inventory.
Yep.
Just a beautiful homes.
You know, I want to talk about there's two I'm excited about. One up at Cam Heights, right below Kamehameha Schools. Mm-hmm. These homeowners have been in the home for a long time.
Over 20 years.
Doing constant upgrades.
It's a beautiful home.
They're moving on is going to be making an opportunity for family, especially if you got all your kids going to Kamehameha Schools. You're like 2 minutes away from school. The other one I'm excited about is going to be out at the Moorings. Mm-hmm. And this one has a boat dock. So you can be living large like a baller because you can get your dock. You can literally go from your back living room, go down the steps off your deck, get in your boat, and you can go to the dock at Costco in Hawaii Kai.
Nice.
You can go to the restaurant. You can go shopping.
So you
in
know,
your boat.
You know the one that I'm kind of excited about that you didn't mention?
Which one?
I just forgot. It's the one that is the duplex in Waianae with 180-degree ocean view.
We call this one the Pink Bunker House because if any of you have gone on that hike for the Pink Bunker, it's a yellow house, and it has like a wave sunrise sunset thing on the gate. So it's got a remote controlled gate, big lot, corner lot, right across from
the
ocean.
Home.
And you have actually two separate living areas within mm-hmm. this home. So you could live in one.
And rent the other.
Like a baller. Mm-hmm. And then you could be renting out the other one. Or maybe you got older kids that you're tired of having them on the couch and you want them to have their own separate living space. This is the perfect home for that.
Or you can just rent them both out.
Rent them both out.
Yeah, and have some good rental income.
Yeah, so exciting. We're constantly, every week, listen to the show. If you don't want to listen to the show and you just want to find out where's your new open houses, go to Team Lally. Google Team Lally. Mm-hmm. Or go to teamlallyopenhouses.com. Back to the statistics, because we got a couple minutes left. Mm-hmm. I just want to remind people, median sale prices are going up. Interest rates are still low. Inventory is still low. It's still competitive. Knowing that it's still competitive for the buying of real estate today, Adrian, what would you say would be the number one or two tips you would give for potential buyers right now?
Well, first of all, you need to be prepared. You got to get your paperwork up front so that you can come in with a very strong pre-approval letter. So we've got a great lender, Pacific Rim Mortgage, Jody Tonga, the mortgage genius.
Yeah.
She likes to do all the work up front. They collect all the documents so that when you present that pre-approval letter, it's like she's turned over every rock.
Yeah.
It's going to get done.
She's she's like the chef that gathers all the ingredients, makes sure that they're fresh. She grinds them, makes sure they're in their proper proportions.
Mm-hmm.
She's not, you know, like McDonald's of mortgage brokers where you just slap a bunch of stuff together. You're in the drive-thru and next thing you know, you got your food. Because, again, that's a different experience. She's more like Ruth Chris.
Well, the other thing, too, is that she does have an excellent reputation here on Oahu.
Yeah.
Probably even statewide, that if they issue a pre-approval letter, that
is done.
They're going to close. They've already done the due diligence up front. They're just waiting on, I guess, the appraisal.
You know, what we say from the west side, mm-hmm. Garen's Bobarin's. She even writes it on the bottom of the pre-approvals. If you're from the west side, she writes right at the bottom, Garen's Bobarin's.
Mm-hmm.
No. Joking aside, she's very serious at what she does. That's why she's called the mortgage genius.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we can call her a mortgage genius because every time we have her on the show, our IQ goes up at least 1 or 2 points.
I always learn something new from Jody.
What I like about Jody and you know, if you're thinking of a seller out there, here's one of the things we do.
Mm-hmm.
We request that all offers that come in that they at least have a conversation with Jody.
Yeah,
because it's half of, or not, if not a majority of the success of getting something into escrow and having it close is what kind of financing and who's their mortgage broker
and how quickly can they get it done.
Yeah,
so
if you're thinking about buying, you're thinking about selling,
mm-hmm.
please book a very, very, very 100% COVID safe Zoom consultation with us. We'll take you through the whole home buying, home selling process. We'll talk about our track record. We'll talk to you about the new ways that we're adapting
mm-hmm.
in today's market with the ever-changing landscape that has given us the success that we've had. We've actually done really well in 2020 and looking forward to 2021 even being better. So bottom line, folks, make sure that you have a very qualified, experienced real estate team on your side, whether you're buying or selling. And if you're looking at property management, who do we recommend?
We recommend Hawaii Pacific Property Management with Duke and his team.
All right.
All right. So thank you for listening and thank you to our sponsors.
Jody Tonga and Derek Tonga, Pacific Rim Mortgage.
Bradley Mariama of Allstate Insurance.
Kenji Vendetta of Pillar to Post Home Inspections.
Janice Merland of Dreamhouse Drafting.
John Speed with Kilauea Pest Control.
Duke Kim Han of Hawaii Pacific Property Management.
Kyle Shimoda of Impact Wealth Solutions.
Wendy Oshiro with 808. And reverse mortgages.
Robinson Villavere of Fine Line Paintworks.
James Santiago of Kaji Cleaning.
If you want to get a hold of any of our sponsors, just Google Team Lally.
And we also want to give a big thank you to Leah Rodriguez, our producer here in the studio.
Yee-hoo!
Make sure to tune in next week. We'll have an awesome guest talking about something that'll change your life
forever. This is the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the guaranteed
sold program. If we can't sell your home at the agreed upon price and or time frame, we'll have it bought for cash.
Be safe and aloha.
The preceding program was sponsored by Team Lally.